I read a verse from a Native American medicine man, and the question was asked, what is life? Is it the flash of a firefly at night? Or is it the breath of a buffalo in wintertime? Or is it that little shadow that dances across the grass and vanishes at sunset? We are, as individuals, flashes in time, but with little help, we can keep the dream alive for the future. And that's what this whole project is about, really, is about preserving our cultures to keep that dream alive. I think I've always done my own thing because I'm really obsessed by the surreal and drawn to the unpredictable. I've always thought outside the box. I've always tried to do the next best thing. How can you up the game? You know, how can you have more fun with what you're doing? I decided that my next project would be documenting American cultures and doing it in the most incredible way I can think of. And so I think, just the way I think, I said, well, how big could I make something? And I tried blowing some pictures up that I had taken, but they really didn't do it very well. So I said, I need a bigger camera. So I figured, well, this is the time I have to kind of roll up my sleeves, dig in, get the welder out, and start rocking on a new camera.
And the only way to get something this size is to go put your insane hat on and try to figure out a way to do it.
Well, okay, so you want a huge camera. And then obviously we understood there's a lot more challenges to it than just building a big box with a lens on the front. But it seemed like it was a perfectly reasonable thing to do.
Now we've got the most incredible negative I've ever seen. We have the ability to make a print that's two stories tall with the detail that no one's ever seen before.
And that's when I decide to combine two things that I like, which is motor vehicles and cameras, and combine them into this amazing machine that travels in a truck.
Mainly it means a lot of blood, sweat, toil, and tears. There are parts of my body still stuck to parts of that camera on the inside. Just this lens took maybe 1,000 hours of CAD and machining time. It weighs 250 pounds. It's carved from solid chunks of aluminum, some of them 6 inches thick, and is extremely precise and extremely heavy.
This camera project will be the last major film project in history, literally the end of the film era. And we have cultures that are vanishing at such an alarming rate. There's a confluence of events here. What we plan to do is to travel to about one culture every week, week and a half, and spend that time with them, doing portraits, doing documentaries and films of the stories, leaving behind something, some kind of a legacy, some kind of a book.
The project has three phases. The first phase is build the most beautiful, functional, highest quality camera that's ever been built in history.
My next step was to get the camera to where the cultures were, because I'd always wanted to photograph cultures. So the camera is designed to visit each culture, travel through the levees and mountain roads of Appalachia.
Drops off at a Native American village or an Appalachian coal mine or whatever we happen to find, and pulls into their world.
My concept is to take this camera, and if there's a Cajun fishing camp somewhere, I'll take the truck and deliver it to the shore, and I'll put the camera on a float and get it to the fishing camp, because it's really important that this camera be a part of that culture. I mean, we're part of that thing at that point. We're not just sitting there watching.
At birth, Mom and Papa call her little boy Ned. Raise him on the bank of a riverbed. A houseboat and tied to a
And when you go into the country and you visit these cultures, they have stories that you've never heard before. They're totally unique. One of the Cajun men I photographed, when his daughter was born, he planted 100 trees in a circle to make a wedding house for her. When she was 25, the trees had grown up and had created a beautiful canopy, and it was just this magical little place.
My name is Greg Girard from the Atchafalaya Basin in Louisiana. When my daughter Rosella was born, I planted a bunch of saplings in a circle to make a special place for her. They grew up together, and last year she was married in her wedding house.
That's one of the things we're also doing with this series. We're bringing stories.
I've selected a subject that represents their culture, a subject that has an incredible story. Incredible what? The crystalline clarity of these super large forms. Take these people, give them a certain level of dignity, but also puts it on an epic scale. You look into their eyes and you can feel something, you know. People look special. It's a story that no one's heard before. It's like we put all of this energy together with a great subject, an incredible camera. We put all that together and we get something, I think, that's pretty special. The third phase is basically bringing these 24-foot prints to life in a mobile exhibit. And the exhibit will be a combination of some of the most incredible contemporary technology and the images.
Remember.